It was senior day in Huntington on Saturday, and among those honored pregame was Woodrow Wilson alum Chase Hancock, who recorded 8 tackles as the defense held the Roadrunners scoreless. Hancock is quick to say it was a team effort, but his impact over the past few years has been a significant one.
The guys were just trying to make sure that the seniors went out on a good note, and it wasn't even about the seniors. It wasn't just the seniors' last game in the zone. It was everybody's last game in the zone. So it was a big night for all of us. They beat us last year in a close game, and it was kind of on the defense. So we came into this game, and we wanted to make sure that that didn't happen this year.
The thing about Chase, from where he was to where he is now, he'll even be better tomorrow, because that's how he goes about things, you know. So, you know, Chase is everything you try and tell people to be.
Offensively, it was a mixed afternoon for Marshall. Isaiah Green did throw 2 touchdown passes and a career-high 387 yards, but the offense managed only 1 touchdown and 3 field goals out of 6 total red zone trips, giving the herd something to think about ahead of next week.
It's always frustrating when you can move the ball all the way down the field, but it just come up short at putting it in the end zone. Like I said last week, we want to live by 7s, not 3s. So we just got to focus on that more and put an emphasis on really focusing in, locking in, we're getting the red zone so we can put the ball in the end zone and generate points.
It was going to be big because they beat us last year. So we definitely have something to prove, especially with these last games. So we're looking forward to it.
Marshall heads to Florida International on Saturday. If the Herd win and Middle Tennessee loses to UAB, Marshall will be part of a 3-way tie atop the East Division. In Huntington, I'm Matt Digby, Newswatch Sports.